All right, on the draw round two, I'm gonna keep this, but man, this deck, when it does not draw opposition or Master of Waves or like a Night Vale Spectre, well, let's just say it's not the most powerful deck in existence, is one way to put it. Let's see, playing against another white deck. The last deck wasn't really a white deck, it just had a Savannah in it, as far as I could tell. So I'm gonna lead with, I guess, Porcelain Legionnaire? Question is, if I play Juicy Apprentice turn 2, do I really want to use it turn 3? The answer is no, not really. I'd rather just play Porcelain Legionnaire and then attack and do some things. Alright. Since I think I am kind of the beatdown. So turn 2, Porcelain Legionnaire. Turn 3, attack. Play Juicy Apprentice. Oh, I get manatized. Alright. Getting Porcelain Legionnaire manatized is not the end of the world. I mean, it's a fine card, but it's nothing spectacular. Maluku does get better the worse your deck is. That is a fact. It's just a powerful card that can win the game by itself. And even though good decks generally have better things to do, this deck does not. All right, I'm not playing Phyrexian Revoker with nothing to name, and I'm gonna play Boilerworks Pullback Underground River. Next turn, probably just use Jushi Apprentice. I don't really want to play Sakishima Student to copy anything, and I don't really want to play a Revoker unless my opponent plays like a Planeswalker or something. And going to 16, let's see if Lingering Souls gets flashed back here. Looks like that might be the case. Lingering Souls is a strong card. Black-white mid-range is generally not great, but Lingering Souls is good. Black-white tokens, more like it. Alright. I guess I might just shoot something with Burst Lightning, since I don't really want to die to an army of flyers, and this Burst Lightning's not getting much better. Yeah, probably draw a card and then shoot one of the spirit tokens. Might as well wait in case my opponent plays an equipment or something like that. Alright. And Burst Lightning. Getting really good value, trading my card for a quarter of my opponent's card. But it's alright, I'm going to draw an extra card, so there's that. Opponent has too much, I might be in trouble here. Alright, Mind Stone's not so bad. Jushi Apprentice, draw a card. Manowar? I think I'm just gonna play Maloku here. I'm gonna attack with the Jushi Apprentice. The reason I want to play Maloku here instead of something else is that if I play Maloku now, the next turn I can use Jushi Apprentice and play Manowar. Obviously, it's kind of annoying if Maloku dies here, but I think if my opponent had a kill spell, they may have killed Jushi Apprentice. Maybe not, though. Alright, looking for a second mana tithe. Hopefully, I don't get Maloku just terrored end of turn. Alright, Maloku has lived so far and can hopefully block the creatures. I don't really have a ton of breathing room here, so waiting to play Maloku till turn 6 might also just not have worked out in terms of I was taking 4 this turn. Oh, that's not good. Skullclamp is just going to destroy me here. I get to play Phyrexian Revoker, but I didn't do that in anticipation of Skullclamp, since that wouldn't really make a ton of sense. So. Yeah, the fact that my opponent's going to draw 4 to 6 cards, potentially more, means I think I just lose this game. All right, this deck looks good. Generally, combining the two worst colors, because black is the worst color, but white's the second worst color, is not great, but Skullclamp plus Bitter Blossom plus Lingering Souls is an insanely good combination. I mean, I guess I'm not technically just dead, but things are not looking good. Opponent just drew 6 cards off Skullclamp. And what am I going to get to do on my turn? Attack for a little bit of damage and play a Revoker. Maybe Manowar a token while I'm at it. I mean, I think that probably is what I do, but that does not make my turn good. Chromox. Well, Chromox is a good combo with Skullclamp. Turn on Bitter Blossom is also kind of nice. Let's see, what are we exiling here? Baneslayer Angel. Yep, not going to need this Baneslayer. Yeah, I'm so dead. I mean, if my opponent's moxing away Baneslayer Angels, then I can't imagine things going well for me. I assume Maloku's dying at some point here. Actually, Ajani's not insane. Alright. Well, I've got outs, kind of, so let's play Manowar. We're going to return the 2/2 spirit to my owner's, or to the owner's hand. Then we're going to attack Ajani for 3. And then we're going to play Phyrexian Revoker, name Skullclamp, and then play a land. Alright. Well, I guess things could be worse. I don't know how much worse, or how it's possible to be much worse, but I'm not just dead. Alright, no more Skullclamps. And pass the turn. Revoker? The more I play with Phyrexian Revoker in cube, the more impressed I've become. The card seems fairly strong. It just is generally, you know, a 2-mana 2-1 that, when it comes into play, turns one of your opponent's cards off. And not that I'm advising high-picking it, but it's got some uses. Alright, what is this? Cloud Goat Ranger. Yeah, alright. That's a thing. Cloud Goat Ranger's pretty good. I'm going to get to Sakashima Studented, but Johnny's still going to be kind of annoying. Turns out my hand was actually pretty good. It's just my opponent drew an extra 6 cards in the middle of the game, so certainly not beating that. Alright, Johnny making Cloud Goat Ranger a 4-4. And I guess no attacks here. Question is, yeah, I guess I still Sakashima Student the Cloud Goat. I could Sakashima Student the Phyrexian Revoker and name a Johnny, but I don't know how much I like that. Alright, I could make a token, but I guess I'm not attacking. Is it Boilerworks? Is going to get tapped down, though. That I do predict. And actually, let's see what we draw. Sword of Fire and Ice. Interesting. Not the right colors, so I don't think I'm going to play it. I actually think I might just name Revoke and name a Johnny here. Problem with naming Cloud Goat is it doesn't actually accomplish all that much. I'm not sure where my blockers are. Yeah, I think I named Phyrexian Revoker. That is very strange. Alright, let's just scroll down here to get a Johnny. We're getting a Johnny Collar of the Pride. Alright. And then I can still make token with Moloku. Sadly, because of Bitter Blossom, it's going to be pretty tough for my opponent to end up with no flying blockers, so Sword of Fire and Ice is really not going to do a whole lot here. Suppose I could have Jushi Apprenticed on upkeep instead of letting the Boilerworks just get tapped. Probably should do that in the future. If my opponent has no removal spells, then maybe I'm okay. Oh, Moloku just got killed, and I just hit okay reflexively. Alright, well, could have had a spirit token, or illusion token. I think I'm actually just dead, though. I guess if I draw opposition, maybe I'm slightly alive. We'll see what happens. Alright, what else is getting cast here? Not that I can beat anything. I think I'm just going to lose regardless. Geez, Sorin too. Alright, my opponent's deck is great. I'm going to go ahead and move to the next game here. What can I do about tokens? I'm not siding in Smashed Smithereens or Falkenroth Aristocrat. No. Alright, our deck is perfect. Or something along those lines.